So I'm continuing my exploration of budget Fi earphones. I was warned not to go down this rabbit hole, but here we are. Now, previously, I took a look at the Blond BL3, and whilst it's not the giant killer that the hype machine made it out to be, it is a really enjoyable earphone and pretty good value for sub $30. Also, recently, I took a look at the QKZ VK1, the TRN V90, and the KZ ZSN Pro, all of which I found lacking, even for their sub $30 or sometimes as low as $10 price points. Today, I'm taking a look at the QKZ VK4. Which is a single dynamic driver earphone that costs as little as £10 or $13, and I'm really not expecting much for this price. The reigning champion of budget Fi for me is still the Blond BL3, but hang on, wait a minute. This is a $13 IEM. It can't be any good, surely. Well, we've got a lot to talk about, so let's get into it. Hey guys, this is Noel, and this is Wheezy Reviews, and if you're new to this channel, each week I take a look at something audio-related and let you know what I think, so if you're into that kind of thing, then make sure you subscribe. So these are the QKZ VK4, which use a single dynamic driver, which is said to have a carbon nanotube graphene diaphragm, and that seems pretty impressive for $13. Now, they also have an impedance of 16 ohms and a sensitivity of 105 dB. And also, let's just pause for a moment because I want you to remember this one thing throughout the rest of the review. $13. Just remember that figure, $13. So the body is made of this lightweight resin in a style that is reminiscent of the KZ-ZST. The version I have here is described as a dazzling blue-purple colorway. There's also a second colorway described as dazzling black, which is a faux carbon fiber look and doesn't really look anything like carbon fiber. Still, $13, right? The earpieces themselves weigh a super light 4 grams per ear without tips, and they've got this rather generic, somewhat KZ style shape. They come with the standard set of silicon tips. We've actually got 4 pairs of silicon tips. In fact, these ones look really familiar. They look a lot like, in fact, they look exactly the same as the ones that were supplied with the TRN V90. Now, I don't get on with silicon tips, so I picked up a pair of KZ's foam tips to go with these. There's nothing fancy about these. They're just generic foam tips. The stock cable is the usual budget Fi affair. It's really thin and has these actually not too bad ear hooks. They're not as stiff as on the Blondes, but actually this cable is not really any better than the Blond cables. This one also has an inline mic and remote as well. These ones also use 2-pin connectors for the earphones themselves. So these are 0.75 mil 2-pin connectors. As usual with budget Fi, it's not a particularly special cable and most people would probably want to upgrade this. QKZ seem to be pretty confident about the VK4. They claim a 20 Hz to 40 kHz frequency response with high-res audio certification. And for some reason, they've also decided to print DSD Hi-Fi Dynamic on the side of the IEM itself, which doesn't really make any sense to me. It's obviously a marketing trick. But certainly, QKZ are definitely hyping up the high-res capability of these earphones. So they talk the talk, but do they walk the walk? Well, let's get into the sound section. And I'm going to start this section with a disclaimer. Budget Fi earphones are often known for unit variants, and this might be true of the QKZ VK4. But I can only report my experience with this one specific pair. And also, as I do not get on with silicon tips, they just don't seal in my ears. I did all of my listening entirely with foam tips. It is entirely possible that the sound signature could change a fair bit when using silicon tips, but I cannot comment on this. All listening was done using lossless sources from my PC through an O2S stack or over Bluetooth using the FiiO BTR3 from my phone. This is to simulate using a solid desktop source as well as mobile usage. Now I'm going to be making comparisons with the Blond BL3, which is my reigning budget Fi champion, as well as the Tin T4, which is my current Qi-Fi benchmark IEM, and both of those were used with foam tips. Okay, so I'm going to start with a spoiler this time because I want to cut to the chase. These sound way better than any $13 IEM has any right to sound. And when I started listening to these, I almost couldn't believe what I was hearing, and I still can't, to be quite honest. So maybe I've gone crazy? I mean, how could a $13 IEM sound this good? Okay, enough with the hype. The bass. They seem to have a decent amount of extension, but they don't sound particularly boosted. They are definitely less boosted than the Blonde BL3. But I think if you think of the Tin T4, and you're probably about there, although perhaps they've got a little bit, maybe a little bit more extension than the Tin T4. And that might make them sound more bassy on certain genres, and it certainly does seem to give the low end a little bit more weight in bass-heavy genres. Although, this is a subtle difference between the T4 and the VK4. There is a really surprising amount of slam capability from the VK4, giving some really great energy to EDM, for example. I really appreciated the good slam on the kick on Polaris by Deadmau5, and that whole track sounded so lively and exciting on the VK4. The same could be said for Deep Jungle Walk by Asterix, which actually got me thinking that maybe the bass is slightly bigger on the VK4 on the whole, rather than just the sub bass. But the Tin T4 isn't really slacking here. I think we're really talking about a very subtle difference between the two. It's not like the huge difference between the T4 and the BL3, for example, because that is a massive difference. So the difference we're talking between the T4 and the VK4 is much more subtle. There also appears to be no loss of quality in the bass. It's incredibly articulate. There's no muddiness, there's no bloating. And honestly, I'm really struggling to find anything to complain about with the VK4. And believe me, I am trying really hard to find something to criticize. In terms of the mid-range, again, I think if you think of the T4 and you're going to be close with the VK4, just like the T4, there's actually quite a bit of energy up in the top end of the mids, never to the point that I personally find it shouty. Male vocals are good, although female vocals I think might be the forte for these. They're good and forwards and also sound pretty good. I listened to a Sine Sweep, and the Tin T4 has its upper mid or low treble energy, depending on where you consider that to be, has that somewhere around 5 kHz. And the VK4, I think, has its mid-peak somewhere between 4 kHz and 4.5 kHz. Neither seems to be particularly more elevated than the other, although I don't have any measurements to go off, so I've got to rely on my own ears for this. So this is obviously more subjective than any graph. But they definitely do have a bit more upper mid or low treble energy than the Blondes, which actually is really quite restrained there. And that does give the Blonde BL3 a much darker presentation than both the VK4 and the T4. Those who prefer a more laid-back sound would probably be better suited to the Blondes. And with that said, the VK4, just like the Tin T4, are not shouty to my ears. And I know that the T4 can be a bit shouty for some people, especially using silicone tips. However, for my ears and using the foam tips, just like the T4, the VK4 are probably in the upper range of acceptability in terms of upper mid energy. But instead of shouty, they come across as energetic and lively, so actually pretty enjoyable. The treble is smooth and somewhat restrained without any hint of edginess or roughness. That might be partly due to my use of foam tips, but I'm unable to confirm this. Obviously, if the silicone tips would actually seal in my ears and stay in place, I could tell you. However, I didn't notice much treble extension past about 10 kHz, maybe 11 kHz. They do seem to roll off a fair bit after this. So for those that like to hear those air frequencies, these might not have what you need. However, just like on the Tin T4, that's probably tip dependent and could be quite different when using silicone tips. In terms of the overall sound signature, I'd say these have a somewhat neutral tilt, and that's harmon neutral at least, with a slightly bright edge to them, which is pretty much exactly how I describe the Tin T4. Now, some might consider these to be slightly more V-shaped than the Tin T4, but I don't think that's due to an overall elevated bass on the VK4, but I think it's more about a slightly greater sub-bass extension on these. Again, without measurements, it's difficult to be totally sure. I mean, despite the similar levels of energy in the upper mids, the VK4 do sound a touch, just a touch warmer in the low end. So they might have a bit more energy throughout the bass range, but we're not talking about a massive difference overall between these two earphones. In fact, this is very subtle. Any differences between the Tin T4 and the VK4 in terms of overall sound signature are very, very subtle. They sound remarkably similar to each other. I've been going back and forth with the VK4 and the Tin T4, and frankly, I've been absolutely blown away by these VK4s. QKZ, by accident or by design, has absolutely nailed the tuning of this IEM. Whatever genre I threw at these, rock, metal, EDM, hip-hop, classic rock, jazz, The VK4 conducted themselves just wonderfully. In terms of soundstage and imaging, I think it's also pretty good on the VK4. Obviously, in terms of staging, yeah, it's not going to be the widest or the most open, but IEMs rarely are. But I'd actually say that it's better than both the Tinty 4 and the Blom BL3s. And certainly, they don't sound at all claustrophobic. And this was quite obvious for gaming. I was playing the Division 2 with these, and these gave me a really good sense of space, which was big enough that it didn't detract from the experience of it being an open-world game. And in terms of imaging, I found to be pretty decent. And also for gaming and competitive shooters like Rainbow Six, I was finding it really, really easy to hone in on the positional cues. Now, does anyone really game with IEMs? I don't know, but unlike the TRNV90 I reviewed a couple of weeks ago, I think you could actually get away with gaming on the VK4 and have a good experience whilst doing so. Okay, so enough with the hype then. I mean, I could just leave it at this. A $13 IEM with a similar tune into the Great Tinty 4, and why not just go and buy them now? I mean, honestly, why look at anything else in the budget spy space if these are this good? Obviously, I'm not here to hype things up, so let's get nitpicky. The problem is I can't really find anything to complain about, but I can give it a go. The IEM, obviously the IEM itself does feel like a cheap and plasticky thing. They only come in two colorways, which frankly, personally, I find them both to be a bit gaudy and cheap looking. The cable is lackluster, but I suppose that's to be expected. All budget Fi earphones tend to have a dodgy cable. And in terms of sound, actually, what is there to complain about? The tuning is spot on. And, well, $13. If I was to get super, super nitpicky with a magnifying glass, I could maybe say that in terms of technical performance, maybe they do start to show their weakness for more demanding tracks with a lot of detail. The VK4 could sound like it is struggling to keep pace, and you start to notice some lack of definition. But that's really not a surprise to say that the Tinty 4 is more detailed, and I really have to get super nitpicky to point this out. Lack of detail is probably the main complaint with the Blonde BL3, for example, and pretty much every other IEM in the budget Fi space. But with the VK4, I'm actually having to really go and look for these issues to find any. For their price, the technical performance of the VK4 greatly exceeds expectation. For the vast majority of people listening to modern genres looking for a cheap IEM due to budgetary constraints or needing a cheap second pair for commuting, this is probably all the IEM that you're ever going to need. The level of detail on offer here for $13 is astounding. So I'm sorry, Blonde BL3, but you just got toppled. So they sound a bit like the Tinty 4. Do they make the T4 obsolete? Well, of course not. Compared to the Tinty 4, the VK4 is similarly tuned with a slightly bright-leaning harmon neutral signature. They only start to suffer when things get a little bit more technical. But in the Tinty 4, you're getting a similar tuning, a much more technically capable driver. It's more detailed. It has a much nicer machined aluminium casing, a better cable out of the box, and a leather storage box. So let's not hype these up to extreme levels. There is no denying that if I had paid $100 for these, I would have been disappointed putting them next to the Tinty 4. But for $13, I'm frankly blown away. Compared to the Blonde BL3, the VK4 are more energetic and lively. They're more detailed with less muddiness and bloating in the bass. The Blonde is warmer, but the low end lacks definition and tends to become muddy. The Blonde BL3 is a fun sounding earphone with a relaxed casual sound signature, and I find them really quite enjoyable. And I can see why people love them so much. They also have a much nicer casing and a much nicer look and feel, but they aren't the best in terms of technicalities. Their more casual tuning isn't for everyone, and their fit is weird to say the least. For those looking for a more capable and more neutral leaning tuning, the QKZ VK4 truly nails it in this price point. Now, I really don't want to hype these up. They're just a $13 IEM with a cheap plastic build and a poor cable. And obviously, they're not as detailed as the Tinty 4, so they're not giant killers. Let's not forget that and start saying that these are giant killers and get all out of hand about it. Obviously, I want to tame that hype a little bit, but for sub $30, I don't know what else there is in this category that can touch the QKZ VK4. Maybe it's the 10T2, which is now down in the $30 price range these days. And also, my journey into Chi-Fi and budget fi is far from over. But for now, a $13 IEM with an excellent tuning and decent detail? Yeah, the QKZ VK4 are the IEM to beat at this price point. Right, that's it. If you like this video, then don't forget to leave a like. And if you haven't already, then please consider subscribing. Also, I'm on Patreon now, so if you want to support the channel, then check the links there in the description. Join at any tier and get access to the Discord, or join at the $5 tier or above and get your name over here alongside these legends. And as always, thank you so much for watching, and until next time, have a good one.